Speak louder. Yes, louder, Pedro. Speak loud, right up there.
Si puede, parle d'ici et un peu plus haut. Votre nom?
Luce.
My name is Luce Puzina.
My name is Luce Puzina, yes.
P-U-Z-Y-N-A.
Were you born in Lithuania?
No, I was born in France. In France.
In France. When did you go to Lithuania?
I did go in Lithuania in
1931.
Did you go with your husband to Lithuania?
Oui, je suis partie avec mon mari.
Yes.
Until 1954,
yes.
You have been living in Lithuania.
Yes,
vous avez habité depuis ce temps-là jusqu'à temps de partir en Lithuanie.
Oui, d'une manière permanente.
Permanent way.
Why did you leave Lithuania?
Pourquoi vous avez quitté Lithuanie?
Je voulais rentrer dans mon pays. Depuis 1946, j'ai demandé le visa de sortie de l'URSS. Il m'a été accordé seulement maintenant. Pendant 8 ans, j'ai voulu rentrer, j'ai voulu revenir.
Since 80 years, since 1946, I've tried to return to my native country, France, and I asked to get the visa to go back to France. But only now, recently, I got the official permission to leave Lithuania.
Were you living on a collective farm after 1941?
Est-ce que vous avez habité dans une ferme collective après 1941?
J'ai travaillé dans une ferme collective de 4 mois, du 1er septembre 1953 jusqu'au 24 décembre 1953.
I worked 4 months on a collective farm at the end of 1953.
Where were you living?
Le paysan surtout, et le fonctionnaire.
The workers are not paid enough, the wages are very low, and that what they are earning is not sufficient to for their living.
Prevent the spread of communism.
Would you say that it isn't true, that would you not say that this is true, that one way to stop communism is not to collaborate with it?
In a way.
And it was about true that if the Western powers took a firm position, whether it's in Geneva, Berlin, or anywhere else, when they deal with communism, they would not only be raising the morale of the people behind the Iron Curtain, but spreading the idea of communism elsewhere.
I think this would be the main question.
And if we talk about actualities now, isn't it true that one of the best things this committee could do would be to create in the United States an understanding of the fact that any attempt to compromise with communism must result in a gain for communism.
Yes. So.
And eventual control by communism.
Yeah, I think so.
And isn't it true that that is the story of Romania, that is the story of Poland, and practically every other country behind the Iron Curtain?
Yes.
And if the people behind those Iron Curtains were convinced today that the United States and other Western powers would cease to try to compromise with communism, it would be an upsurge of spirit in those countries?
Yes, very much.
That's right.
Mr. Chairman, could I make this comment regarding Mr. Treska's testimony? The Congress of the United States, as you know, Mr. Tresca, in 1951 authorized the creation of a special committee known as the Katyn Massacre Investigating Committee. And I happen to be chairman of that committee, and Congressman Mikovich, who was a member of this committee, was also a member of that committee. And testimony was introduced at our hearings during that investigation regarding the prisoners that were taken in the fall of 1939 from Poland and also the early 1940s, in the early 1940. But of course, our committee did not take testimony as to all the statistics regarding Polish prisoners, which you've just presented to this committee. And I might state that testimony was presented stating that in 1939, right from Warsaw alone, there was 150,000 or more prisoners taken by the Russians, and in the fall of 1939, especially in the early hours of the morning, the Soviet police separated the leaders, Lithuanian by birth. She would be unable or would be stopped from leaving Lithuania.
Est-ce que vous aurez la possibilité de quitter l'Italie?
Non.
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 Definitely not.
No, not.
If she were a Lithuanian, she couldn't get out, is that it?
Yes, that's correct.
She could not leave if she were a Lithuanian.
I could not leave Lithuania if I were born Lithuanian.
That's all. Mr. Peel? Well, deporting people from Lithuania to Siberia and slave labor camps.
Est-ce que vous savez quelque chose? Est-ce qu'on toujours encore aujourd'hui on déporte de Lituanie des gens pour des prisons, des camps forcés?
La dernière déportation que j'ai vue a eu lieu en septembre ou octobre 1951.
Last deportation which I have seen, witnessed with my own eyes, was in September or October 1951.
Counsel, just before you proceed further, Mr. Madden, I think, would like to have a word to say, perhaps, just about...
Oh, why don't you strike my question? I'll repeat the question and strike it so everybody can answer.
Mr. Chairman, I recognize among the officers and witnesses for the Polish Army and Polish Honor Free Poland gathered here today some of the witnesses who testified 2 years ago when the Katyn Massacre Committee, which was created by Congress in 1951, held hearings here in London. I want to state that the experiences and the valiant fight that you officers who are gathered here today put up for Poland back in the beginning of World War II will go down in history as one of the outstanding examples of the historic fight that all Poles back through the centuries have demonstrated through their patriotism for a free and independent Poland illustrates, to my mind, that the people of Poland will never cease fighting and working as long as Poland is held in communistic slavery That fight will never cease until Poland is free. And I want to commend this group here today for being one of the many leaders in that fight that has been going on and will continue to go on until Poland is free. Mr. Chairman, if I could just add another witnesses that we had and who testified at length on the Katyn massacre investigation, and I don't know, understand he's to appear here as a witness, and that's the great hero and leader of the Polish armies during World War II, General Andrews. I understand he's to appear.
That's correct, Mr. Abbey. Mr. Counsel, will you proceed to examine these Polish officers, and we are very happy to have with us this morning.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. And Congressman Batten, you.
Mr. Chairman, in addition to your statements regarding General Andrews, I might say for the record that 2 years ago last month, the Katyn Massacre Committee, which was authorized by Congress in 1951, held hearings in London. The officers of the Polish government in exile that contributed so much in unraveling that international crime where 14,000 and more Polish officers, military officers, judges, lawyers, doctors, and Polish leaders were massacred by the Kremlin. And I will add to your statement in commending General Andrews for the outstanding cooperation and work he not only gave the Katyn Committee, but is also giving the committee of which Chairman which Congressman Christian is chairman.
Company is weak. I think the same is today. If the United States go ahead directly and thanks, all people will go with the United States. But if the United States speak only words and there are no facts, all people is weak.
Mr. Chairman. General,
I think, excuse me, I think that the United States military men don't understand today his leadership. This is my opinion. It's not.
Mr.
Five of these communists accepted into a coalition government.
The Prime Minister? In March we went to Moscow.
Yes.
But the coalition with the communists lasted since the time when Russia went into the war. When Russia went into the war, the four communists in London went into our National Council.
That was before you and Benish went to Moscow.
No, the government was accorded in Moscow. Before Moscow, the communists had no posts in our government. No posts. They didn't want it. State Council, yes. No, you didn't ask about the positions of the communists in the State Council, in the government.
In the government.
They had no posts before our going to Moscow.
Then we didn't have any communists in the government in 1941.
No one.
Now, why did you and Dr. Benish believe that you could get along with the communists?
Yes, I see. In that time, the Russians for us were friends, and they assured us that they will grant all democratic liberties. Of course, if we had judged the communists after their program and their literature, the Marxism and so on, we couldn't believe it. But we we tried to believe. It was the situation which did us try to believe the communists.
Now, Mr. Spears.
Thank you very much.
Yes, I would like to just get one thing in the record. All during this time that the Russian army, the communist army, was at the very gates of Warsaw since 1939, is that correct?
No, the Russian armies came to the gates of Warsaw, they approached to the gates of Warsaw in July 44.
July 44?
Yes.
When did they really start their take way to bringing about that day we're all looking forward to, when Poland will again be free, as promised Poland, under the Atlantic Charter, and that you men will be back in command of an army in Poland that is on a free and democratic basis, like I know each one of you would like to have it.
Was not too high. Being completely overtired, the man has only one idea, to have a rest. To have a rest at all costs. That is exactly what the nations are brought to the stage when they will be so overtired by the general atmosphere, confusion, and
in Poland, more than 300,000 people. They were excellent, and for against the Germans didn't make a very big effort. From this side, we had a lot of victory from our airmen, from the Navy, from the land troops. And after all the sacrifice of Stalin, gave the agreement to move a lot of people to Persia.
The advantage of our hindsight rather than foresight, do you believe that Dr. Benesch,
yes,
of course, at that time was a wise one?
I see, but I can only answer that Dr. Benesch did what, in his opinion, was necessary to save the democracy in Czechoslovakia.
I understand that, but yes. if he had knowledge then of the true tendencies of communism, which evidently he must have had some inklings of, he probably wouldn't have done this.
And of course not. And mainly he believed that the Moscow government will help him in getting the communists to reason.
In other words, he thought a little communism was all right as long as you didn't have too much of it.
Yes.
He didn't know that once you start with a little communism, there's no end to it.
Yes.
Now, you mentioned the fact that Mr. Mikulajczyk of the Polish government, under much worse circumstances, acceded to the desires of the British and the American government and did enter into the so-called Lublin government.
Yes.
But it's a fact, is it not, that that Stanislaus Mikulajczyk did so individually, but not the rest of the Polish government in exile?
Yes, but he was not, I don't think he was alone. He has his party. It was a certain party of the poorest, the agrarians.
It was only that one group.
Only that one group.
And the rest of the Polish government in exile resisted the effort.
Yes.
And as a result of their resistance, the British government and the United States government eventually withdrew the recognition of that government.
Yes.
So as I
what we're trying to find out, as I understand our task, is what happened in these countries after the communists took over. That's our purpose, really.
Yes, yes.
Since we've gotten into this speculation, I think it's fair to bring out that undoubtedly there was in your mind and in the mind of Dr. Benesch not only the fact that the Western powers were pressuring you to cooperate with the communists, but also the fact that in 1938 you had been abandoned by the West to the Nazis, practically.
By the Western?
Yes, by France and Britain and by other two. That must have been in your thinking, wasn't it?
Yes.
And you suffered under this terrible Nazi occupation, as you've indicated. Now, if I understand that situation correctly, the people of Czechoslovakia were about ready to take anything in order to get away from the Nazi tyranny. And they'd had a bad experience with the West insofar as helping them out was concerned once before. So actually they had very little choice to make. Isn't that a fact?
Yes.
I talked with Dr. Benesch in Prague. I spent 2 days there with him in 1946. And my recollection is...
You went under the congressman who went to Prague.
No, I wasn't...
Nothing.
I wasn't a congressman then. But I was down there and spent some time with him. My recollection is that he told me that really you didn't have any choice. I had the impression that you were really had a pistol at your head.
Yes, that's right.
Well, that's accurate, isn't it?
Yes.
And also I had the impression from the people I knew in Czechoslovakia at the time that you were hopeful that you could somehow, by getting back there, work this thing out,
manage it quietly.
So now we do know that that was not possible, but nobody knew it then. Also, I think it's fair to suggest to you that, and I'm sure all of the members would agree, that Dr. Benesch didn't make any more mistakes than the rest of us made. The only difference is that we got right out
that we could not come to an agreement with the communists before we went to the liberated part of the Republic via Moscow, because in our London State Council, there
we continue.
In Moscow, where we arrived on March 17, the Soviet government didn't directly interfere in our negotiations. Some kind of pressure was implied in the fact that we, the guests, were given to understand that 8 days had been reserved for our visit.
What date was this, Mr. Smith? What date?
We are fully representative and democratic government. I did not consider that our government at the time was not. This is just to show you that the slightest sign of encouragement from the West, we did our best to show the world that we did not wish this domination. So after this declaration from the United States, I called Groza and told him about Mr. Bratiano's party. Manu.
I spell it. Manu, M-A-N-I-U, I believe.
Yes.
And the other person?
Bratiano. B-R-A-T-I-A-N-O. So, the government was the same, except for these two people. And this government was there to prepare
to make some profitable things for my country, under the condition that I will tell something which nobody would trust outside the world, so that relatively the price what was put for me
Will you raise your right hand, General Bohr? You do solemnly swear that you will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do solemnly swear that I will tell the truth, and only truth, so help you God.
Thank you. General Kalczynski, you do solemnly swear that you will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
Yes, I do.
You do. General Munter, do you understand English?
Yes.
You do solemnly swear that you will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
Colonel Pommian? Dick.
Mr. Chairman, I wish to join in the comments you made in reference to the anniversary of the uprisings in East Germany, to the free people of the world. They appreciate the significance of that movement, and I sincerely believe that as time goes on, we'll find that in other parts of the world where people have the desire to be free, will actually demonstrate in a similar manner when the appropriate time comes about.
Would you tell me, please, what subject or subjects you taught to the children?
Qu'est-ce que vous entendez, qu'est-ce que vous avez appris aux enfants?
Professeur de français, de langue française.
French language.
You didn't teach any history then?
Pas d'histoire.
No.
The other teachers teach the children that Russia is protecting the Lithuanians from the capitalist world, do you know?
Est-ce qu'il y a cette propagande aussi que la Russie soviétique protectrice de Lituanie contre le capitalisme, contre le coureur de guerre venant de ce côté?
Oui, elle protège et elle a libéré la Lituanie.
First, the Russians are saying that they liberated us, they liberated Lithuania, and secondly, that they are protecting us and will protect.
What were some of the reasons that the children gave for going to church when they were called upon before a group to explain the fact that they had been at church?
Est-ce que vous avez entendu quelles étaient les raisons, par exemple, quand les enfants étaient appelés de se rendre compte pourquoi ils sont allés à l'église, ça que vous avez raconté avant. Quelles raisons que les enfants ont dit?
Les enfants se troublaient et ne savaient que répondre.
The children had been rather troubled and didn't know what to answer.
Are the children taught that they are now, since the so-called liberation, a part of Mother Russia? Or are they taught that they are still an independent nation of Lithuania? Do you know?
Est-ce qu'on dit aux enfants qu'ils sont maintenant toujours encore indépendants citoyens de Lituanie ou déjà membres de la grande mère Russie?
Oh non, on leur dit qu'ils sont des Lituaniens indépendants.
Oh no, they are told that we are independent Lithuanians.
Yes.
When Dr. Benes went to Moscow on one occasion, you said that he did not participate in any of the conversations
with the communists. He didn't participate in our conversations with the communists because he was the president above the parties.
Well, he went there for the ride then.
For
the ride.
No, he had to return. He had to return home.
He did not perform any official function there except the social function. Is that correct?
Yes. In 43, you ask about 43? No.
First 43, he was there alone. I mean,
yes,
not with you.
Then he discussed and with the...
General, you're speaking now about those 16 men who were invited to Moscow together with Stiplikowski, about which we've had testimony.
Yes, that's right.
He was one of those.
Yes, from this group.
at that time was chief of staff of General.
And this time he was and my chief of staff. After a very long meeting,
they do that here as well as in.
Actually, to prevent the spread of communism. Would you say that it isn't true, that would you not say that this is true, that one way to stop communism is not to collaborate with it?
In a way.
And it was about true that if the Western powers took a firm position, whether
it's... Yes.
Until 1954. You have been living in Lithuania.
Yes, I
Vous avez habité depuis ce temps-là jusqu'à temps de partir en Lithuanie.
Oui, d'une manière permanente.
In a permanent way.
Why did you leave Lithuania?
Pourquoi vous avez quitté Lithuanie?
Je voulais rentrer dans mon pays. Depuis 1946, j'ai demandé le visa de sortie de l'URSS. Il m'a été accordé seulement maintenant. Pendant 8 ans, j'ai voulu revenir.
Since 8 years, since 1946, I've tried to return to my native country, France, and I asked to get the visa to go back to France. But only now, recently, I got the official permission to leave Lithuania.
Were you living on a collective farm?
Speak louder.
Yes,
louder.
Speak loud, right up in
the microphone. What name?
Luce.
My name is Luce Puzina.
My name is Luce Puzina, yes.
P-U-Z-Y-N-A.
Were you born in Lithuania?
No, I was born in France. In France.
In France. When did you go to Lithuania?
I did go in Lithuania in
1931.
Did you go with your husband to Lithuania? Oui, je suis
parti.
In Geneva, Berlin, or anywhere else, when they deal with communism, they would not only be raising the morale of the people behind the Iron Curtain, but spreading the idea of communism elsewhere.
I think this would be the main question.
And if we talk about actualities now, isn't it true that one of the best things this committee could do would be to create in the United States an understanding of the fact that any attempt to compromise with communism must result in a gain for communism?
Yes.
And eventual control by communism. And isn't it true that that is the story of Romania, that is the story of Poland, and practically every other country behind the Iron Curtain?
Yes.
And if the people behind those Iron Curtains,
after 1941,
est-ce que vous avez habité dans une ferme collective après 1941?
J'ai travaillé dans une ferme collective de 4 mois. Du 1er septembre 1953 jusqu'au 24 décembre 1953.
I worked 4 months on a collective farm at the end of 1953.
Where were you living?
Le paysan surtout, et le fonctionnaire.
The workers are not paid enough. The wages are very low, and that what they are earning is not sufficient for their living.